Studying these groups and, like you said, having a window into their world, where do you think things are going now? Are they emboldened by what happened in Charlottesville? Are they scared? I mean, we saw a white supremacist crying his eyes out at the idea of being arrested. Do people actually understand what's at stake if they're, you know, going to be fighting in this fight?
I don't know that people understand what's really at stake. I don't think if they really did, that there would be all these liberal op-ed columnists attempting to create some kind of equivalency between anti-fascists and white supremacists. What happened in Charlottesville, it was they saw it as a make or break moment for the openly white supremacist element of their movement, because the alt-right has two wings to it. One is openly white supremacist. It's only for white people. No LGBTQ people are allowed. Jews aren't allowed. And then there's another wing that's more moderate, in which all of these groups are allowed. And this was a bid for taking the front seat in the driver's car by the openly white supremacist wing. It was a very special rally. It, for them, they thought it was going to be their entree into the mainstream, and instead it was a big black eye for them. But now they're saying a lot of dangerous things. Some people are distancing themselves from the alt-right label, but people who are the white supremacists, the avowed white supremacists who are involved in it, are saying some very dangerous things. They're saying things that might imply that they're going to go underground and start a campaign of violence, or that they're simply going to stop trying to appeal to more moderate people and just create a very hardline movement. And either of those are dangerous options. So they're reconsidering their tactics at this point.